This is Dr. D. Govardhan, Professor in the Department of Aeronautical Engineering, Institute of Aeronautical Engineering, Hyderabad. Today we are discussing introduction to vibrations, pre and post vibrations, simple harmonic motions, and related important terms used in vibrations. Introduction to simple harmonic motions. Let us consider a particle which is moving along the circumference of the circle of radius as shown in figure with the uniform velocity. Let P represent the position of the particle after time t at let P be the representative position of the particle after time t. Draw the projection of point P on the vertical diameter of the circle. The n point is representing the projection of point P. When the particle is moving along the circumference circle from x position to y position in counterclockwise directions, its projections when viewed from the right side is projected on vertical diameter at zero. On moving in counterclockwise directions, its projection also moving in upward directions along the direction of y, and it coincides with the y when P point reaches at a position of y now. And when the particle moves from y to again x dash position, its projection on vertical diameter again starts move downward directions from y to o, again from x dash to y dash, again come to o dash y dash position. Similarly, again y dash to x dash, again goes to the center point to O position. Or in another words, when the particle is moving along the circumference of the circle, its projection on vertical diameter, it moves to and fro. This moment is called the moment of this, its projections on vertical line is treated as vibratory motions. When P completes one revolutions, the n also completes one vibrations about the vertical diameter. This to and fro motion of the projection of the particle is known as simple harmonic motions. Generally, it briefly it can be written as SHM, which is shown in a figure. Velocity and acceleration of a particle moving with simple harmonic motions. In the same figure, when the particle is moving along the circumference of the circle with the uniform velocity in counterclockwise directions, its projection on vertical diameter executes simple harmonic motion as shown in figure. Let R be the representing radius of the circle and omega is representing uniform angular velocity of the particle which is moving along the circle. Let P be the represent the position of the particle at a given instant from x position. Therefore, the angle turned by the particle, assume theta, it now becomes W into T, that is the product of angular velocity and time. So the displacement of its projections on vertical line, it start from zero and occupy new positions n, which is shown in figure. Hence, y is equal to, that is the position of its projection on vertical lines is on, which is equal to r sin theta according to the trigonometric relations. Since theta is representing angular displacement, it can be written as w into t now. Or in another words, y is representing r sin omega t. So, differentiating these equations with respect to time, it now becomes dy by dt equal to omega r cos omega t, which is represented here in equation number 2 now, where dy by dt is representing this velocity of the particle, which is given by w into r. Cos omega t, it can be written as, according to the trigonometric relations, 1 minus sin square omega t now, r which is also equal to w into r, 1 minus sin omega t is equal to, according to the trigonometric relations, y by r, hence it now becomes y by r whole square. So, v is equal to w into under root of r square minus y square. It is represented in equation number 3rd. Now, differentiating once again the equation number 1 with respect to the time t, it gives the acceleration of the particle which is moving along the circumference of the circle. It is given by d2y by dt square equal to minus of omega r square sin omega t now. So, which is equal to minus of omega square into y now. Because r sin omega t is equal to y, on substituting this equation in this one, it now becomes minus of omega square y now, which is represented in equation number 4th. So, by using this relations, when the particle is moving along the circumference circle, the displacement is given by y is equal to r sin theta, where y is representing the position of the projection of the particle p on the vertical diameter. The velocity of the vibrating system, that is on vertical lines, is given by v is equal to, and differentiating once again, w into r square minus y square. Similarly, acceleration is given by d2y by dt square equal to minus of w r square sin omega t, r is also equal to a is equal to minus of w square y now. Now, from these relations, we observe that the acceleration of vibrating body, or which is executed simple harmonic motions on vertical line, is always proportional to the its displacement from equilibrium position, that is O, and it is acting in opposite direction of its movement, or in other words, toward the equilibrium position. The general condition of simple harmonic motions, the acceleration is always directed toward the center, known as the reference point or the mean position. The acceleration is proportional to the distance from the point, vibratory motions. When an elastic body is such as spring, beam or the shaft are replaced from its equilibrium position by keeping just one end in a fixed position, by the application of external forces, when the forces are released, it executes vibratory motions. This is due to the reason that when the body is displaced from its equilibrium position, the internal or elastic energy that is present in the body, when the forces are released, these elastic or strain energy forces, they are at in the directions to keep the body its original position or equilibrium position. When the body reaches the equilibrium position, the whole elastic or strain energy is converted into kinetic energy, due to which the body continues to move in opposite directions. Similarly, when it moves again extreme positions, the internally the elastic or strain energy that is developed, again it keeps the body in equilibrium positions, or the body moves toward the equilibrium positions. In this way, the vibratory motions is repeated indefinitely. Here, the shown in figure, this is the vertical shaft. Here, one end is fixed, other end is free. Let the end of the free end, it is having a disc B. By the application of the force, it is also called disturbed force. The body is displaced from its equilibrium positions to towards A, and it is released now. When the body is moving toward the point A, elastic or strain energy that is developed in it, but when the applied force is released, these elastic forces try to keep the body again at B position, that is equilibrium positions. While coming from A to B, the entire strain energy is converted into kinetic energy. Hence, the body tends to move in opposite directions toward the point C now. So again, when that kinetic energy is converted into strain energy, this strain energy again keep the body toward the point B now. In this way, the motion of the vibratory system is continuous repeatedly indefinitely now. This motion is called here simple harmonic motions. Some of the important terms we are using in vibratory systems, they are amplitude, cycle, oscillation, beat, and periodic time. The first one is the amplitude. It is the maximum displacement of a body from its mean position when it is executing simple harmonic motions. In a figure, here the particle is moving along the circumference circle with a uniform velocity omega. Its projections on vertical diameter y y dash execute simple harmonic motions. The position of the projections on vertical lines, it gives the amplitude of the vibratory system. The amplitude means it is the maximum displacement of the body from its mean position. The maximum displacement is given by here, OY or OY dash, when the particle is moving along the circumference of the circle. Here, according to the geometrical construction, the maximum amplitude, the maximum displacement, it is equal to the radius of the circumference of the circle. Second, cycle. It is a motion completed during one time period. Third one is the oscillations. It is one complete vibration of a body. In a figure 1, when the body moves from Y to Y dash position, then back to again Y, it said to be have completed one oscillations. That means, here, when the particle is moving now from X, its projection is at 0 position now. When the particle is moving along the circumference circle, That means when it goes x to y position, its projections on vertical diameter meet y again. From x dash again it comes to O. From x dash to y dash again it comes to y dash position. From y dash to x dash again it goes to O position. That means when the particles completes one revolutions, its projections also exit one complete oscillations. That is nothing but from y to y dash again going back to y position. This is called oscillations. Beat. It is half of the oscillation. When the body moves from y to y dash position or y dash to y position, is said to have completed one beat. Periodic time. It is also called time period. It is a time taken by the particle for one complete oscillations. Mathematically, periodic time is given by 2 pi by omega, where omega is representing the angular velocity of the particle which is moving along the circumference of the circle. It is obvious that the periodic time of a simple harmonic motion is independent of its amplitude. Generally, it is expressed in terms of seconds, frequency. It is the number of cycles completed by the vibrating body in 1 second is called frequency. Generally, it is represented as 1 by t, where t is representing periodic time. Usually, it is represented by the letter n. The unit of frequencies is h. Briefly, it can be written as hz. Types of vibrations. There are 3 types of vibratory motions are there. They are free and natural vibrations, forced vibrations, and damped vibrations. In order to have simple harmonic motions, the body which is in equilibrium positions, like in previous case we have taken the shaft, or it may be spring, or it may be an elastic body having uniform cross section, having negligible weight, it is suspended vertically, and its end consists of disc or bob. When it is displaced from its original position by the application of disturbed forces, and when it is released, it exhibits vibrations. These type of vibrations are called free or natural vibrations, because the vibration system is executing without effect of external forces on each cycle, forced vibrations. In forced vibrations, when the body vibrates under the influence of external forces, then the body is said to be under forced vibration. The external force applied to the body is a periodic disturbing force created by the ambulance. The frequency of the disturbed force is equal to the frequency of the vibrating systems. When the frequency of external forces, when it is constant with the natural frequency of vibrating system, the resonance takes place. The effect of resonance is it increases the amplitude of the vibrating system, and also it gives noise. Generally, it should be avoided in engineering field because it may damage the machinery or the equipment. Damped vibrations. In damped vibrations, when there is a reduction in amplitude of over every cycle of vibration, then the motion is said to be damped vibrations. This is due to the fact that certain amount of energy is possessed by the vibrating system is always dissipated to overcome the frictional resistance to the motion. The best example is in a free or natural vibrations, when the system is vibrating, we are neglecting the frictional force offered by the air, because the air is always support the motion of the vibrating system. After some time, it will come to equilibrium position. When we are neglecting the friction force offered by the air, then it is called here natural vibrating systems. When we are considering after some time the system comes to rest positions, or in other words, the amplitude of the vibrating system gradually decreases every cycle of vibrations. Finally, it comes to zero velocity. This type of vibrations called damped vibrations. Generally, damper vibrations that are preferable now, that damper in a machinery which is used to reduce the vibrating system, which is developed during the cutting operations. Types of free vibrations. Depending the position of the axis of the vibrating system, and the movement of the vibrating system with respect to the axis, these vibrations are classified into three types: longitudinal vibrations, transverse vibrations, and torsional vibrations. Here, consider a weightless constraint. It may be spring or the shaft, whose one end is always in fixed position and other end is carrying heavy disc, which is shown in figure now. This system may exude one of the three above mentioned types of vibrations, such as longitudinal vibrations, transverse vibrations, and torsional vibrations. Okay, the figure which is shown in figure 2, it executes longitudinal vibrations. In longitudinal vibrations, the particle of the shaft or the disc moves parallel to the axis of the shaft, which is shown in figure. Then this type of vibrations are called longitudinal vibrations. While executing longitudinal vibrations, the length of the shaft elongated and shortened alternatively, hence tensile and compressive stresses are induced in the shaft. Here in the figure, one end is fixed, B is representing mean position of the shaft when it is carrying a disc at its free end. The disturbed force is applied on it to disturb its equilibrium position from B to C position. When it is released, that a disturbed force is released, the elastic or strain energy which is developed, the forces act in such a way that to keep the body at B position now, at mean position. But while going from C to B position, the strain energy is converted into kinetic energy. Again, it goes up to A position. Again at A, the strain energy which is developed by converting kinetic energy into strain energy, again it comes to B position. That nothing but here it executes vibrating motions. But while vibrating, the length of the shaft becomes elongated and shortened alternately, Hence, compresses and tensile stresses are induced in it. And second, transverse vibrations. Again, we are considering the same shaft, which is fixed at O position now. Here, and OB is representing that axis which is in the vertical, and it is assumed in equilibrium position. By applying disturbed forces on the shaft such that it deviate or having displacement approximately perpendicular to the shaft from B to A position. When the disturbed force is released, the strain energy which is developed in it is converted into kinetic energy, hence it comes to A, B position. Again, this kinetic energy converted into again elastic energy, it goes to up to C position, or in other words, it is equal to vibrating motions. But the displacement of the disc is approximately perpendicular to the axis of the shaft. Hence, in this case, since the shaft is alternately bending on both sides of its axis, the bending stresses are induced in it. Torsional vibrations. In torsional vibrations, the shaft of the disc moves in a circle about the axis of the shaft. It is shown in figure here, see now. The vibrations are known as torsional vibrations. In this case, the shaft is twisted and untwisted alternatively. Hence, torsional shear stresses are induced in it. Okay, thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.